Amen. Look at where we are. The Bible says that if I'm going to meditate on my new life, what I have to do, in my determination, I have to become humble with God. In my humbleness, what it really says to me is that I've lowered myself to a level to where God can deal with everything around me. Now, there's some pinpoints in our life to where we're confident where we are. We're confident what I can do, I'm confident what I can say, I'm confident about what's around me. Those are pinpoints in my life, and I don't need nobody to bother those pinpoints in my life. I don't need nobody to touch those pinpoints. I got it together. I'm right there. But what God does is God takes those pinpoints that we're confident with, and He changes our pinpoint because we don't need to be dependent on ourselves. God takes those pinpoints and change them around that we'll be dependent on Him. Now, whenever those pinpoints change, what God does is, because I like small beginnings, because I'm going somewhere, I recognize that God has changed my pinpoints. In Him changing my pinpoint, I adjust to those pinpoints. So, okay, God, where am I going next? Well, what actually happened is because I thought I was right at the right place, and I really wasn't. When God changed and shifted me, He shifted me in the right direction I need to go, and because by now I'm going to always be greater than my former, He put me in the right position. He changes where I am. My mind changes on where I need to go. What I actually do, if I change from a Toyota to a Mercedes or a BMW, what actually happens in my life, God says to me, my mind changed. I look at myself differently. I got to see myself differently. Well, you think about it. Why do I need to change from a Toyota to a BMW or a Mercedes? Well, what actually happens, you don't have to change your car, but what you do, you change your status. Amen. How many of you women in here that got jobs, that they changed your job status, and you had to change clothes? You can't wear the blue jeans you used to wear. They want you to wear suits now. And now when you get out of the car, you got your suit on now. And you get out of the car, and even in the glass in the car, you want to make sure everything. What you've done is you changed your status. And now that I'm going up, I want to make sure by me going up, not only will I see I'm going up, I want everybody else to see that I'm going up. I've changed my status. God said, I'm going to change no pinpoints in your life to where when you start changing your clothes, not only do you feel better about you, everybody around you feel better about you. You change who you are. You change your hair. Amen. There's a lot. I went to a wedding yesterday. Amen. Nice wedding. Everybody came in. And I noticed every woman that came in had a different haircut. I noticed that. Every woman that came in had a different haircut. Amen. But they had clothes on that they'd never worn before. And then you probably say, why was he looking at that? I always noticed stuff. I'm not nosy, I just noticed stuff. I notice people. Because there's always a message in everything that you see. It's always. So every woman in there had a different haircut. Now, what if every woman would have came in with the same haircut? It would have been as exciting to look at if all of them had the same cut. You say, yes, no. Because see, there were some women in there looking at the haircut. And most women now, I got four daughters, y'all, so I know something about a woman now. Listen, every woman likes a cut on a different, they look, don't y'all look at people's cuts? Yeah. Now, men don't look at cuts. We just got our hair cut. But women look at cuts. Listen, that might look nice on them. Well, told me the other Sunday, the pastor heard me and said that. Amen. I don't believe a woman ought to have a bad attitude. You know where you put your hats on, the bandana on, you cover your head, and let me tell you something. And this is no reflection on nobody. I'm trying to tell you how to move from where you are. Whenever you seem like you're going to have a bad hair day, y'all know how you do stuff without going to the beauty shop. You know how to fix yourself up. Y'all know how to hit it real quick, don't you? My car, I'll keep my stuff in my car. from God. My ladder is greater than my former. My layover days are over. I'm ready to go somewhere. All year long, I've talked about how we can experience some things in our life. I talked about last Sunday, you have preferred. And God has chosen you for a work. He chosen you for a day such as this. Well, the only thing he says to me is that once he gives me what I need, take care of what I have. And what he does for me is he gives me more than what I have. If he takes it from me, he's going to give me something back. Y'all remember when he promised Abraham and Sarah Isaac, and then he told him to take Isaac to the mountain to get him? Well, Abraham knew if he took Isaac, he's going to have to give another Isaac back. Because he promised him a promised child. And that's what he said, now, if you take Isaac, he said, I know. He told his servant, we're going up on the mountain, but he said, we shall return. That's what the Bible said. And what he really said was, he said, if God take Isaac from me, he's going to have to give me another Isaac coming off the mountain. Because that was his promise. Whenever God promises you something, God won't take it and won't give you something back. Well, God said this to Job. He said, Job, though the beginning was small, he said, yet the latter end should break the increase. How many are ready for an increase in your life? How many are ready for God to do something different in your life? How many are ready for peace to come in your life? How many are ready for a double portion of God's anointing in your life? All God is saying is, let the latter be greater. Now hold on and increase where you are. If you understand where you are now, you didn't make it to be this way always. He said, I'm going to increase where you are. We got to get to that place where we can understand this God doing and not me doing. I got to understand my small thing is going to be bigger things one day. I got to understand that one suit is going to turn into 10 suits. That one dress is going to turn into 15 dresses. My bad hat is going to turn into a hat dress one day. I got to understand it's not about my small thing. It's about what God is really doing in my life. You don't have to look at other people and say, and they got that, and that's the reason they can do it. And God gave it to them. Amen. Amen. If God gave it to them, can you give it to me? People used to always say, man, you got a shop, you got this, you got that, that's why you do. No. See, what you don't understand, if I don't work, I can't get a check. Your check is guaranteed every Friday, every 2 weeks, your check is there. My check is never. Stop sitting there, you're gonna miss the plane. Yeah. Stop sitting there, you're gonna miss the plane. Look, you gotta be, they tell you to be 2 hours ahead for a ride on the airport so you won't miss the plane. You can get your luggage in, you can get your ticket. And I'm telling you how good they arrange this stuff on these smartphones. You can pull your ticket up on your phone and not have to go through the line and scan your phone. God is changing our layover. How many of you ready for God to do something different in your life? I'm tired of us as a people letting other folk stop me. If you go into Atlanta and you got a layover somewhere, and there's somebody not going to Atlanta, start talking to you. They don't care whether you miss the flight or not. They just talk to you. You say, man, I got to get my flight. You say, just give me 1 minute. Let me tell you. That 1 minute comes 5 minutes in. And they keep calling. They said, last call for flight number 7149. And you listen. You hear this flight call, but get this fellow. Keep talking. Instead of you hurting their feelings and tell them, so look, I got to go. You keep talking. I want to be cordial. I want to be nice. And you miss the plane because he's talking. And what he do after they close the door? He says, man, I'm sorry, I kept talking. But now you got to wait for another flight. God said, the day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. He said, I'm calling your name. I'm calling your flame. He said, I want to make these things great for you. If you keep reading Job, the Bible said that Job doubled in everything he had except his wife and his children. God gave his 10 children back. His wife was there. His servants were there. His house was there. His riches were there. Why is it? Because he was determined to understand that my latter days is going to be greater than those. I went through some stuff. Went through the mud. Went through the storm of life. But yet, I'm right there. Job said, I trusted God. And in me trusting God, I stood my stand with God. The devil tried to make me curse God. But I stood right there. He ready to bless your life. He ready to bless your life. April, he's ready to bless your life. Yeah, last night I was sick. I got sick yesterday. All night long, I was struggling up and down, up and down. And in my mind, I said, well, I ain't going to church in the morning. Call somebody that can preach in the morning. And the Lord said, I didn't need that. By 12:30 last night, or this morning, the Lord reminded me of something, Gene. This is what the Lord reminded me of. The Lord said, by my stripes, you heal.
You got scripture embedded in you, but yet there's no God.
Somebody with a commitment on their mind, God, to say, for God I live and for God I'm willing to die. I pray that somebody will show up, oh God, and say, God, send me to this place. Yeah, you work what you have in your spirit. I pray that somebody will find what I'm not sure of knowing, oh God. It takes all that we have, oh God, to grow ministry in this area. I pray that somebody will come throughout the next year, God, that everything that you told us must happen, God, the promise that has been made, oh God, it will be validated within this year to come. I pray, Pastor, now for new people, new numbers, new walks, oh God, new determinations, oh God. I pray, Pastor, now that in all that we do throughout the next year, the things we write down to do, the talent that you've given us, oh God, increase will come in us. We decree it now that it's already done. Every woman in this place, oh God, will have an increase in their life. Every man in this place, God, will have an increase in his life, God. Home will become home, oh God. Thank you, God, for relationships. That now we'll be true, we'll be transparent. We'll be real to ourselves. I bless you, God, now. For everything you do within this place, God, you will get the glory. I pray, Master, that we'll see that we started small. But in our lives, we will have increase in our lives. So, God, now, we want to speak into our future. We want to speak just as though we have already been there. God, thank you now for showing me what you've shown me. I believe it was Paul that went into the third heaven and showed the thing that was unlawful to talk about. I feel like I've been there, God. So since we've already been there, manifest the deeds around me, God, that you'll see a God beside you there and another. I bless you, Master, now for this day. I honor you for what you're doing in this day. Thank you for what you're doing in this season. Bless us one by one, God. Bless us collectively, the investment of the church family. I thank you, Master, now for this day. I bless you for the offering that we receive this day. I bless you, God, for increase in all things. I continue to ask, oh God, that you will counteract anything that the devil has already put on our agenda to mess with us this day. Move it down, God, and give us the authority, oh God, to understand that we are conquerors, more than conquerors, Him that's around us. So I thank you, Master, for blessing us for this day. It's in Jesus' name that we do pray this day. Amen.